constructed an app-based history. Until a history how it started, then there's no official cause that come off pointing fingers at the power company. You think about power, you think about sparks, think about drive, but you can see how electric is.
Right, and you know, what does that mean when, you know, this isn't like a company where we can just sue them and say, let's put them out of business, right? You need your utility. You need it to work. So there's a lot of focus on, was your utility at fault? How can you make this work? We got wildfires again in California, and again, authorities looking at the power companies. And this has happened more than a dozen times already. Now, here's the evidence just so you know in what's happening right now. First, in the fire near Sacramento, the campfire you see there, this blaze was reported just minutes after a PG&E electric line went out nearby, and also where the fire started, a nearby PG&E tower is badly damaged. And just a day before the fire, PG&E reported an email to residents saying that workers, they needed to get onto her property to fix sparking wires, but they need permission. That's her private property. But then you go to the Southern California fire, the Woolsey fire, the electric company Edison says they also had an outage near where the fire likely started. So it could be a spark there that was the cause. Now you should know that both of the companies are saying there's been no determination of the cause. It says the PG&E statement. Edison has a very similar statement to this too. Both had already taken steps for putting in insulated wires, high-def cameras. But you know what that means when they have to spend a lot more for fire prevention? It means higher monthly bills for people. Also, there are big lawsuits already being filed. You can imagine that there's more on the way. Now, I just want to say this because Robin was just mentioning about the sparks for a second. This is from Hurricane Matthew. You can see how a power transmitter is sending out sparks.
Yeah, but hold on. Here are the ways that power lines can spark. First of all, they're up on wooden poles, right? The wind can snap the poles, the tree branches can do if you have all those problems. You get the spark sitting in dry grass, and then see a problem. If we have that Hurricane Matthew, I did want to show it for a minute because I want you to see what happens when the transformers really go out. That's a big problem. And what happens is you don't just have the sparks up there. If that transformer box, sometimes what they have is a thing that's called a restart. So it's meant to automatically restart the power. What happens when the restart sits to dry grass? It's trying to restart the grass. That's a big dramatic problem that people are speculating might have been part of what happened. Speaking of big and dramatic, when you think about, obviously, people are the first concern when it comes to the wildfire. There's a whole lot of horse country in these areas, and, you know, most of us have Shepherd dogs, right? But out in California, people have horses, bulls, donkeys, pigs, and other problems, other pets that need to be evacuated and animals from the fire. So I just want to add that people like Dr. Sandra Bullock gave $100,000 to the Humane Society in Ventura County as part of the rescue for that. So ways to help you can help, if I can talk, the California wildfires and the people caught up in that, cnn.com/invest. All right, so Christina Petraffic with more on the ways that celebrities are helping. And everybody who's just saying she's affected by it out there wants to have a hand in it. Taylor Cook of the Big Bang Theory, also a big animal lover. So she's deciding to go to social media and use it to generate money for animal rescues as well.
My queen, that is your room from below.
So, that means my room, right? It's over. So, Kaylee is encouraging her 4 million Instagram followers to choose from several animal rescue organizations she listed on her account that are on the front lines right now and could really use some funds. She also highlighted a prison dog training program called Paws for Life, which she says is temporarily housing 21 dogs that have been displaced by wildfire.
I'm on my way now to shelter in California to give people to have evacuated their homes. It's not my advocate for that. I'm encouraging people to stay home.
So Lady Gaga visited a Red Cross shelter yesterday to help lift the spirits of evacuees and let them know she's in this with them, or armed with both pizzas, coffee, and gift cards for people at the shelter. And she also asked her fans to make a donation. The shelter was set up at a high school in Los Angeles. And this picture, Gaga standing in front of a wildfire map that's draped over a trophy case, and it really gives you a sense of just how much has changed there. Remember a few days ago, Gaga documented her own evacuation on Twitter, wondering if her home would still be standing when she returns. And fighting wildfires day and night, most Pfeiffer had just woken up and advertised the day's role of the crew fighter served barbecue to the firefighters. This is in Los Angeles, and it was Bull's personal creation he's been working on as he recently ventured into the world of becoming a grill master. Both he and the fire department shared pictures from the visit. Bull captioned it, "It was an honor to cook for you." Bull recently launched a barbecue company called Fast Meat Barbecue. So everybody out in California is just trying to lend a helping hand in any way they can and any avenue they can get it.